So we talked about and we started CRM in the last class. And I want to recap what we did in the last class. So CRM 7.0, that is what we are doing. So CRM functions and architecture, what are the different things which we can do in SAP CRM? What we can do in SAP CRM web client user interface. And then what we can do, logon and personalization as far as SAP CRM is concerned. So that is what we will be discussing in all these different topics and all these different areas. So SAP CRM functions and architecture. So we discussed and talked about in the last class one is desktop, another one is my phone. Okay, that is fine. Okay, so when we discussed in the last class and when we talk about SAP CRM has these three functions. So SAP CRM allow me to do sales, allow me to do service, and allow me to do marketing. So we can do three functions in SAP CRM. Using SAP CRM, these three functions we can do. Now this is another thing which is important, because when we're talking about SAP CRM, in SAP CRM, we only have these three functions. We have only these three functions. We have a sales, we have a service, and we have a marketing. Okay. Now this is architecture. We discussed that in the last class. Now in this architecture, some of the things which is important for us to understand that sorry, my voice is still a little bit of a problem. So in SAP CRM architecture, we can this is SAP CRM. SAP CRM can integrate with ERP. SAP CRM integrate with the BI, SAP CRM integrate with the supply chain, SAP CRM integrate with the web portal, SAP CRM integrate with the field application, SAP CRM integrate with the web channel, SAP CRM integrate with the client center. So SAP CRM architecture allow us to integrate SAP CRM with the various different functions of SAP CRM. Okay, that is what we can do using SAP CRM. SAP CRM is central function, but SAP CRM integrate, it take the data to ERP, it send the data, it take the data for BI, it receive the data, it send the data to SCM, it send the data, it receive the data from web portal, from NetView portal, from field application, from e-commerce portals, or to the interaction center, basically means call center. That is an example of architecture of SAP CRM. So that is where the architecture of SAP CRM come into the picture. This is an example of SAP CRM. So in SAP CRM, we can integrate with ERP. SAP CRM, we can integrate with SCM, we can integrate with the BI. Now, if you look at carefully here, there's an adapter, there is a plugin. Adapter is a program, and plugin is a program. Two programs having a dialogue with each other. So SAP CRM is an adapter for R3 to connect with the ERP. You have an adapter for BW, connect to BW. Adapter for SCM, connect with SCM. All these different adapters are inherently available in SAP CRM. Some point of time, when we talk about the middleware, we'll talk about these adapters as well. And we'll show you that where this adapter management and different middleware objects are defined in SAP system. So we talked about there is something called middleware. So middleware is the tool to send and to receive the data in SAP. And for sending and receiving the data in SAP, we can use SAP CRM middleware. SAP CRM middleware we talked about there is something called SAP CRM Web Client User Interface. SAP CRM Web User Interface is basically a user interface which is only meant for the purpose of business users. Only meant for the business users. And that is where the SAP CRM Web User Interface comes into the picture. And the web user interface is an additional user interface. So when you look at it, if you look at my screen here, this is SAP GUI. This SAP GUI is what you're using. This SAP GUI, which you see at your screen, is what you have used when you use SAP R3 for SD. So for all sales and distribution SD exercises which you've done so far, we have used SAP GUI. GUI means graphical user interface. Graphical user interface is a user interface, and using this user interface, we are doing various exercises. We create a sales order and purchase order, inquiry, quotation, delivery, cash order, cash sales, and quotation, and contract, all these different exercises. And then we also did a lot of configuration. We have done all those exercises and all those configuration using interface which is there in front of you in your screen. That is called SAP Graphical User Interface. In SAP CRM, apart from SAP Graphical User Interface, we also have an additional user interface that is called SAP CRM Web Client User Interface. So Web Client User Interface is an additional user interface which is primarily meant for business users. So it has been created for the business user. This is written in something called Business Server Pages or BSP. So Web Client User Interface is written in a language that is called BSP. BSP is used for the purpose of allowing business users to log in into it. That is where the business server pages or BSP come into the picture. Different authorizations and all that we can do. SAP GUI for administration and administrative tasks. SAP GUI. This is SAP GUI, which is what we've been using. SAP GUI will still be used. So when we are doing administrative task, then we will still be using SAP GUI. So when we talk about customizing, when we talk about system administration, when we talk about ABAP programming, when we talk about workflow, when we talk about user ID profile, when you talk about system monitoring, when you talk about the middleware, for all those different administrative and the configuration task, we will still be using SAP GUI. So that basically means we have SAP GUI for all different tasks in SAP. Okay, so we have a SAP graphical user interface. Okay. So we will still be using SAP GUI for all our administrative tasks. Okay. That is one of the important points to understand. There is a separate user interface, but that user interface is only meant for the purpose for business users. When we talk administrative task and all that, we still use SAP GUI. Good morning, Navil. So okay, customizing. So we talked about that. We logged into SAP and all that. The next unit which we discussed and talked about is called account management. That is the chapter number 2. We did some exercise also here. I'm only repeating. So far, I'm just repeating what we did in the last class. I just want to repeat because last class, I was not all that well. I was actually sick and all that, but I still did a class. Okay, so that is where we have unit number 2. In that we talked about the concept of accounts and business partners. Okay, so we create and we talked about that concept. Business partners in applications. Now, when I say business partner in application, we can do different concepts, different categories. Now, this concept of business partner, which we're talking about, is not in SD. This is only in CRM. Now, another very important thing is in SAP S/4HANA, SAP SAP CRM concept of business partner is used. SAP SD concept of customer master is not applicable in SAP S/4HANA. So this concept of business partner, which we are using, is unique to CRM. This is not in SAP SD. SAP SD does not use this concept of business partner. SAP SD use the concept of SAP SD use the concept of customer master. SAP CRM use business partner, but in SAP S/4HANA, in SAP S/4HANA, this concept of business partner, which we are learning here in CRM, is used. So SAP S/4HANA does not use SD concept of customer master. SAP S/4HANA use CRM concept of business partner. So that basically means SAP SD concept of customer master is not applicable in SAP S/4HANA. But this concept of business partner in SAP CRM is carried in SAP S/4HANA. Okay. That is one of the fundamental change in SAP R3 and SAP S/4HANA. So now I'm also teaching SAP S/4HANA. So when you're learning this concept of business partner, you're not only learning SAP CRM, but you are also learning one of the important perspective point and concept in SAP S/4HANA. It's one of the important things to understand. Good morning, Navil. Good morning, Raghavendra Srinivasa. Good morning to you as well. And good morning to the class. I hope this point which I'm describing here is understood. Good morning, Ajar. Bhai Sahab, aa gaye aap. Ajar Bhai Sahab. Class se pehle check kar liya kar ek baar. Ajar. एक बार हाई फाइव दे दो, हुकुम नहीं है कोई मेरे भाई. ओके, वंडरफुल, ग्लैड दैट यू कुड जॉइन. मैंने कहा तेरे को कोड भेज दिया था, आई थिंक यू गॉट माय कोड एंड ऑल दैट. ओके, सो दिस बिजनेस पार्टनर कॉन्सेप्ट व्हिच वी आर टॉकिंग हियर इन एसएपी सीआरएम is one of the fundamental new functionality which has been introduced in SAP S/4HANA from SAP SD perspective. And this functionality, which is there in SAP S/4HANA, is actually taken from SAP CRM. It's also taken from SAP CRM. So SAP CRM, this functionality of business partner, is applicable, relevant, useful, not only in SAP CRM, but also available in SAP S/4HANA. So in fact, when you are understanding this business partner concept, you in a way is understanding SAP S/4HANA. So when I'm explaining to you business partner concept, I'm explaining to you SAP S/4HANA. Now another thing is, in SAP CRM, there are several concepts of actions, middleware, etc., which are carried in SAP S/4HANA. And those concepts from SAP R3 SD are not applicable in SAP S/4HANA. This is a one very important point to understand, that business partner concept and a few other concepts which we'll talk about, like actions, we're going to talk about product master, and then several other concepts which we'll talk middleware. A lot of those concepts which we learn in SAP CRM, they are not only applicable to SAP CRM, but they are also applicable to SAP S/4HANA. In fact, these SAP people are very badmas. They have taken a lot of these concepts from SAP CRM and they have introduced them in SAP S/4HANA, and then SAP SD functions they have replaced. We talk about org model. That org model is also introduced in SAP S/4HANA. So a lot of changes which are there in SAP S/4HANA. So almost all those changes are carried from. So most of functional change or new functionalities carried in SAP S/4HANA are taken from SAP CRM. So these guys have taken from SAP CRM and then put them into SAP S/4HANA. So business partner and org model and actions which do a lot of other functionalities and middleware. So a lot of those concepts are from SAP CRM, and now they put those concepts in SAP S/4HANA. I hope these points are explicitly clear to you. So when you're learning SAP CRM, you're not only learning SAP CRM, you're inherently, you're learning various concepts which are applicable in SAP S/4HANA. It's a very important point to understand. In fact, this business partner concept which we're talking here, this business partner concept is absolutely copied, completely copied in SAP S/4HANA. Then what we have learned in SD, that customer master concept, that concept is redundant. That concept is not applicable. Raghavendra, anything for you, my friend? For you and Ajay, there are two people which is my top priority. Thank you. Okay. अच्छा तेरी तो शादी भी करवानी है अभी ओके ओके वंडरफुल सो नाउ लेट्स अंडरस्टैंड दिस कॉन्सेप्ट सो बिजनेस पार्टनर कॉन्सेप्ट इन एसएपी सीआरएम द कस्टमर मास्टर कॉन्सेप्ट व्हिच वी लर्न एसडी इज नॉट एप्लीकेबल हियर दिस इज अ डिफरेंट कॉन्सेप्ट एंड दिस इज अ कॉन्सेप्ट व्हिच इज कैरी फॉरवर्ड इन द फ्यूचर. So what we are saying here is, we can have account And we did some exercise in the last class. I wasn't even that well. I had traveled from India and all that, so I was all under the water. So I will do those exercises also again today. So we create an account, we create a contact, we have an employee. Account means my different kind of accounts. In SAP, CRM account is divided into these three categories. If you see here, so then my account is divided into these three categories. Then account, we can have individual account, we have a corporate account, and we have a group account. So account is divided into these three categories. So here we have an individual account, we have a corporate account, we have a group account. So we have these three accounts. Account, individual account, corporate account, and the group account. Now, what is the meaning of these three? Let's understand. Individual account, corporate account, group account. Let's understand these three concepts. So individual account, when you're selling to an individual, so when you're selling to Mike, when you're selling to Thomas, when you're selling to Richard, when you're selling to Nancy, when you're selling to an individual, that is called individual account. Then we have a corporate account. Corporate account basically means when you're selling to a corporate. So in corporate, I'm selling it to Johnson & Johnson, corporate account. We are selling it to Pepsi, corporate account. We are selling to Coca-Cola, corporate account. Then we can also have a group account. Now, what is the meaning of a group account is? Group account basically means when we are selling to group of people. Group of people. So one is a common example of group of people in our day-to-day life is when we are selling to, let's say, we are selling a loan, mortgage to husband and wife. So selling to husband and wife is an example of a group. You're not selling to one person. You're selling to group of person. So we can have individual account, corporate account, and group account. Then apart from account, we have a contact person. Contact person is an individual. Contact person is an individual on the customer side. So now what does it basically mean? So on my Pepsi, my contact person is Michael. In Apple, my contact person is Thomas. In Costco, my contact person is Richard. The contact is the contact person on their side. Then employee means, who is our employee? Who is our employee? That is what we are talking about. Who is our employee? Our customer service representative. Who is our sales manager? Who is our sales supervisor? Who is our customer service rep? Who is our general manager sales? And that is the employee. So account, contact, and employee. business partner in any party, or the any party with whom you are doing business. Business partner is a very simple, straightforward concept. I would like you guys to make a note of this paragraph. So which I highlighted, again make a note of this paragraph quickly, please. So business partners are any party in which your company has a business interest. You can create and manage a business partner currently centrally for different business transactions. Now, business partner concept is very, include everything. Any business transaction for any external or internal partner, your sole to party is your business partner. Your ship to party, your business partner. Your peer, your business partner. Your vendor, your business partner. You're doing interaction with the doctor, your business partner. You're doing interaction with the bank, your business partner. If you have a supplier, there is a business partner. So you can have business partner of different type, of different nature. So that is where we can have a business partner and different kind of business partner. We talked about what is account. We talked about what is contact. We talked about what is employee. We talked about the corporate account, individual account, group account. Now here in the CRM, there is something called grouping. I would like you guys to make a note of these two lines, grouping, business partner creation. Number assignment is determined by the grouping. So make a note of that, grouping. 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 Now, what is the grouping? What is the grouping? So, if you go to business partner, this is the maintain business partner. Business partner. This is a transaction code BP, and this transaction code BP is used everywhere. So when you go to SAP S/4HANA, you will see the same transaction code BP. So same transaction code BP applies. Same transaction code BP applies. So this T code BP, which we are learning in SAP CRM, is also applicable in SAP S/4HANA. In SAP S/4HANA, it's also called transaction code BP. So transaction code BP applies in SAP S4HANA also. So now when you look at it in front of you, we have these three categories: person, organization, group. And that is what we see here. Account, group, and person. Organization, group, and person. Okay. Now, if you go back here, if you look at my screen carefully, if I go to organization or group or person, anywhere for that matter, then we have something here called grouping. Now, this is a grouping. Now, grouping is a field. This is interview question. So this question will also be asked to you in interview. So grouping is the field which is used in SAP CRM for defining number ranges. So for defining number ranges, we can use this field. So this grouping field is used for defining the number ranges. You want internal number range, you want external number range. You can define different number ranges, and those number ranges configuration is applied. And that number range concept is controlled by this field called grouping. So this concept of grouping is being controlled. So now, can a contact person be an employee also? Yes. The contact person is an employee of the customer. Employee is my company's employee. Then we can have a grouping which control number range, internal number range, external number range, what kind of number range is this. I would like you guys to make a note of this paragraph. This is the paragraph which control the number range, that how we can create number range. So this is the configuration part, IMG, implementation guard, cross application, components, business partner, basic setting, and number range and grouping. So please make a note of that as well. So this is the band path. Okay. Now these are some of the example of business partners. And you see the various examples. My patient, if I'm a doctor, is my business partner. If I'm a bank, my borrower is a business partner. If I'm a tenant company, then my tenant is a business partner. My customer is a business partner. My debtor is a business partner. My employee is my business partner. My contact person is employee. My supplier is a business partner. My organizing member, plant and store location, they all business partner. Business partner concept is very broadly, widely used. Any entity, internal or external, with whom your company is doing a business transaction, internal or external, is an example of a business partner. The example of a business partner. Now, I would like you guys to make a note of this paragraph, business partner role. Make a note of that quick. Business partner role is used to classify a business partner in business terms. A business partner is used to classify a business partner in business terms. Make a note of this paragraph. So business partner role is used to classify a business partner in business terms. The role you assign to a business partner reflects the function it has and the business transaction in which it's likely to be involved. Business partner role, define what kind of a role this business partner will be performing. What kind of role this business partner will be performing? That is controlled by business partner role. Now here, we have a business partner role. And you can create your own business partner role as well. These are different business partner roles. These are different business partner roles. You can create your own business partner role as well. And we're going to create our own business partner role as well. So business partner role. So here, we have a business partner role. Business partner model in CRM differs from that of ERP, backend system customer master. That is what I was describing, that this business partner concept, which we are learning here in CRM, is drastically different than the customer master concept which we have in the backend ECC. In the backend ECC. Okay. In the backend ECC. And this concept, which you are learning in SAP CRM, has been carried forward. Is carried forward is carried forward in S/4HANA. Okay, that is where that concept of SD is redundant, and this concept of business partner is carry forward in SAP S/4HANA. Okay, this is called business partner category, person, organization, group. If you look at here, person, organization, group. These are three categories: person, organization, group. So these are the three categories: person, organization, group. These are called categories. This is called business partner category. This business partner categories describe the categories of the business partner. The business partner categories describe the categories of the business partner. Additional category cannot be defined. These three categories, person, organization, group, they are predefined. You cannot create a new category. That is not permitted. You look at here, person, organization, group. These are the three categories, and only these three categories. And no other category is allowed. You cannot have a new business partner category. New additional category cannot be defined. You can only have three categories. Business partner category cannot be changed after a business partner has been created. Make a note of that also. So when you create a business partner, which you're going to do, so when you create a business partner, you choose first a category. Whether you are creating an organization, whether you're creating a group, whether you're creating a person, you choose first the category. And once you selected the category and you create a business partner, then that category cannot be changed. Make a note of that as well. So they're predefined. You can create as many as grouping. You can create many, many business partner roles that you can configure. But business partner category, you cannot configure. They are pre-configured. Okay? Those are the pre-configured. Business partner role. In the business partner role, you can have a different role. We talked about role defined, what kind of business function this is being done. This is the menu part where the business partner role can be configured. Make a note of that. We're going to create our own business partner role also. So we're going to create a new business partner role that we're going to create in the system. Okay, make a note of that. Okay. Okay, we can define a business partner role. So business partner role. We're going to go there and we're going to create our business partner. Now, this is a concept that is called business partner relationship. Now, this concept of business partner relationship is also unique to. Yeah, is unique to. So business partner role and business partner grouping, business partner category, and then we also have something called business partner relationship. Business partner relationship is also described a concept, a concept which is unique to SAP CRM. Now, in that, we have a something called business partner relationship, in which you can link two business partners. You can link two business partners, and that relationship can define what kind of relationship they have. This is just one example of relationship we see here in the figure 13. So this is one company, RMG Inc. This is another company that is called Smith and Partner. And then between RMG Inc. and Smith Partner, we have a relationship. And what is the relationship? Between this period to this period is a stakeholder of 80%. RMG Inc. is an 80% stakeholder in Smith and Partner. So that is one of the important perspective, which you can do in SAP CRM. So here, thank you, Raghavendra. Thank you for your kind words. I appreciate it. So business partner relationship. So business partner relationship, when you are relating two business partners together, and their relationship could be of different type. And that is why we have something called business partner relationship categories. So business partner relationship categories basically describe what kind of a categories of the relationship is, because relationship could be of different types. So what kind of a category it is, what kind of a relationship it is, that is defined by a SAP. Okay. Business partner relationship category. Category, because relationship could be of different type. This is another example of a business partner relationship. So I have an organization and I have a person. Organization is Pepsi. Person name is Michael. So Michael is a contact person in Pepsi. So when I go to Pepsi, I meet Michael, because Michael is my contact person. So Michael is a contact person for organization, Pepsi. Pepsi has a contact person, Michael. So between Michael and person, we have a contact person relationship. Now, this business partner relationship category functionality is only there in SAP CRM. It is not there in SD. And this functionality is also carried forward in SAP S/4HANA. And is very powerful, because then you can link business partners with each other in different ways. Now, this is another functionality that is called integration of business address or BAS. Business address services. Now, what is the business address services? Let's understand that. And the first and foremost, pay attention clearly, look at very carefully. Any number of addresses for each business partner. Any number of addresses for a business partner. Look at the first bullet point. Any number of addresses for the business partner. Now, the limitation in SAP SD is that when you're getting a customer master in SAP SD, You can only create one address per partner in one partner, because you might have done SD customer master, right? When you're getting a customer master in SD for one business partner, you can only have one address. More than one address is not allowed. You cannot do that. But in SAP CRM, for one business partner, you can have more than one address. That's an additional and unique capacity and capability. This is address determination, where you can define different address type and what are you using. You can define template. A template is basically when you can create a template, and which is used for copied data, so faster data entry. And then you have something called buying center. Buying center basically means when you have more than one person which is involved, in the buying process. So for example, let's say you're selling CRM. You're selling CRM to Pepsi. So when you're selling CRM to Pepsi, who you're selling to? You have multiple people. You have a, you know, a purchase manager. You have a vice president sales. You have a CIO. You have an IT director. You have multiple people. So each of those people are connected with each other, and that is the example of a buying center. A contract sheet is a report where you can have a consolidated report and exercise. So now I'm going to do exercise, but I will do exercise after the break. So we're going to take a 10 minutes break, and after 10 minutes, I'm going to do this exercise. Okay, so 10 minute break, and we're going to do exercise after 10 minutes. Okay, I'm back now. So let me recap a few things which we have discussed. So we talk about the concept of business partner. In the business partner, we talked about there is something called business partner categories, in which we said there are predefined business partner categories. In the business partner category, we talk about there's a account, there's a group, there's a person. Then we talk about there's a concept of business partner role. Now, business partner role is an example of a role performed by a business partner. So that is the classification of the business partner from the business perspective. So sole to party is a business role. Ship to party, business role. Bill to party, business role. Peer, business role. Vendor, business role. Then we talk about there is a grouping. And we discuss that grouping is used for the purpose of defining the number range. So we want internal number range, we want external number range, different type of number range. We can control those numbers by the grouping. And then we also talked about there is a concept of business partner relationship. Business partner relationship concept is not there anywhere else except in CRM or business partner. Now, business partner relationship defines what kind of a relationship we can have. So that basically we define business partner relationship. So business partner relationship basically describes what kind of a relationship exists between different business partners. So that is where the business partner relationship come into the picture. So the business partner relationship basically talks about what kind of relationship two business partners we can have. Then we also talked about there's another concept which is called address management. So in SAP SD, there's a limitation that when you're creating a business partner, that one business partner, you can only have a one address. So you can only have a one address per business partner. If you want more than one address, then you cannot have that in business partner. That is not allowed. But in SAP CRM, you can have that. So that is where we can have a business partner address. Okay. Now, I want to do some exercises. So I want to do some exercises. These exercises I did last week, but in last week I wasn't all that well. So I want to repeat exercises. So I want to do business partner exercise. In a business partner exercise, first and foremost, I want to create a sole two party business partner. Sole to party business partner. Then I want to create contact person business partner. Then I want to create employee responsible business partner. Then I want to link sold to party to contact person using business partner relationship. So please make a note of that. And then I want to link sold to party to employee responsible using business partner relationship. So make a note of this. Okay. So make a note of these elements. Okay. Make a note of these exercises which I want to do one by one. Make a note of all these steps, please. Okay. Okay. Now, let's do this exercise. So, I want to create a sold to party. So go to business partner. Now, I'm creating a sold to party. Pay attention. I go to organization. So, because sold to party is organization. Then, in the business partner role, I select sold to party CRM 000. Hit create button, and in the grouping I have a 0001. Okay. Okay. Now this is my customer master. So I have a customer. So let's say I'm creating a customer called Costco. And I enter the date and all that. So Costco, search term, house, street. So we have a Plainfield Avenue, house number 1234, postal code. City, country, and the region. The same address. So this is a address which you are entering in SAP. Nothing different, unique. It's just an address. Okay. Now, I have a Plainfield Avenue, house number 1234, postal code. That address appears here. 1235 Plainfield Avenue, New Brunswick. I go to identification. Here we can define what kind of legal entity, what date it was founded in the C sector, what kind of industry sector this belong to. You can choose, you know, commercial, agriculture, whatever. Taxation information. So country. We have a region, tax type, tax group, none. What kind of business partner? Data origin basically means from the data came. Sometimes data come from you know, some other systems. We can say data and then we have payment transactions, what kind of bank ID. We can put classification. So here in the classification, we talked about what kind of a customer it is. Is a customer, is a prospect, from what date, how do you integrate with R3. So you can integrate R3 with a different account group. Okay. So in the account group, what kind of account group it is. So in the account group, we can integrate SAP to a different account group. Then we can also enter the text and all that, you know, it's a free text field and all those different things. Okay. Then here we have a sales area data, which is specific to a sales organization. So here, so you get into sales organization, distance channel, division, customer group. You can define your incompletion procedure, different customer group. You can go to shipping tab. You can define your, you know, Incoterm, your delivery priority, shipping conditions, high priority, medium priority, low priority, standard shipping, delivery control. If you require any kind of partial delivery, etc., we can define that in the system. We can go to billing. Customer pricing indicator, exchange rate, currency, payment term, price list, etc. And we can have all these, and then we can set. Okay. And then we save it. So see the message in the bottom. business partner has been created. So we make a business partner concept. So we created a sole to party business partner. Now I want to create a contact person business partner. Back. We go to maintain business partner. We go to organization. In the organization, no, we want to contact person. So for the contact person, I want to go to person. For the contact person, I want to go to person. In the person, from the business partner, I wanted to choose contact person. I want to select contact person. So now, okay. Now, what is the first person? So this first person is Michael. Jordan to bahut ho gaya. Michael Rutherford. And language. Okay, so we talked about which house number, route number one. Country, region. So we enter the address and all that. Okay, so this way we have entered the address. Address overview, we have a different address, identification, male, marital status, he's married, nationality, any business partner external, if we are taking the business data from outside, data origin, payment transaction, we can define his payment card, bank detail, long text, then type whatever. And then we can save. So in the bottom, we have a business partner 415795 created. I make a note of it. So we created a business partner contact person. We did a business partner contact person 415795. So we created a contact person business partner. We entered sole to party. We enter the contact person. We enter the employee responsible. Now I want to create employee responsible. So I want to create employee responsible. So now I go to contact person. And from the drop down, I choose business partner role employee. Create. First name Donald Trump Senior. We put a house, Trump Boulevard, house number, postal code, SAP New York, country, region. Then we have a status overview, identification. Unknown is, no, I think not known. Okay, male, long text. Just give me 1 second, guys. I'm getting one phone call. I'm back now. So now the data, and we save it. Okay. So see the message in the bottom, 415796. We credit employee responsible. Actually, in case of Donald Trump, it should not be employee responsible. It should be employee irresponsible. That partner function, employee irresponsible, is not there. So we created employee responsible. We have no choice. Okay. Now I want to link sole to party. 415-794 to contact person. Then I want to link sole to party to employee responsible. Okay. So that is the linking we are going to do. So now the second part we're going to do is linking. Using the business partner relationship. We could have sold to party, we could have contact person, we could employ responsible, and I want to link sold to party 415794 to contact person 415759. I want to link sold to party 415794 to employ responsible 415796. So we're gonna talk about it. Okay. So make a note of these steps. Now let's go back. So now I go back. I go to business partner. Hit enter. So this is my sold to party. This is my sold to party. Now, if you look at carefully, and I go to change mode, so this is display. Make sure that you're in change mode. And then you go to relationship. So see here. And the relationship. Okay, make a note of that. Okay. And then we go to the relationship here. In the relationship, first I want to select contact person. So this is the contact person. So now I want to select contact person. Okay. Okay, so we select contact person. In the contact person, I enter my contact person. This is my contact person, 415-795. I hit create button. It opens business partner attribute tab. So what is this contact person's department? Agent purchasing. What is this function? He's head of purchasing. What is this authority? Is a joint decision maker. And other things we can type, what is the telephone number, what is fax, what is email address. We can put if who is the sales employee, you can go to usage, in which you can assign it to a particular sales area, if it's linked to any specific sales area, and partner function. So we can also create a partner function. We can say it's a contact person, and then we hit enter. So what we did, we have linked Costco to the contact person. So Michael Rutherford is now our contact person. And we have linked that contact person to the business partner. We have linked them to the business partner. So we can do that. So now I want to do second exercise where I want to link sole to party to employee responsibility. So here I go to employee responsible. I select another one and then I enter my employee responsible. Hit create button. And then select my sales organization, distribution channel, division, partner function. So sales clerk. So Donald Trump Senior is a sales clerk in Costco. So for the Costco, his role is a sales clerk. And we hit enter. Now that is what we have. So we have a Costco 415-795, and then we have a contact person. This is the contact person. 415-796. So this is a contact person, my brother phone. I've been employee responsible. And employee responsible is 415-796 and Donald Trump Senior, and he's a sales clerk. And this is it. So that is how we can use business partner. We can create business partner, different roles. And we can also link the business partner to SAP as well. Now, I want to go to the next topic. I will talk to you. Okay, one more thing which I want to talk. I also want to talk about, address management. Address management means allowing maintenance of multiple addresses for one business partner. Make a note of that. You can maintain different addresses of business partner. You cannot do this in a SAP SJ. That functionality is not available in SAP SJ. You cannot do this functionality in SAP SJ. This is not possible. That is address management. So we are doing address management. Make a note of that statement, please. Okay. So now, this is my sole to party Costco. I go to general data. In the general data, I have address overview. You see here, we have address overview. Okay. Now, here I have one address. Look at carefully. 1234 Plainfield Avenue, New Brunswick, New Jersey, 07619. So we have one address here. So we have one address. Now, in this one address, one of the problems which we see that if I go to create button here, and I can enter different address, route 287, house number 888, postal code 201005, city, Dallas, country, and the state. And hit enter. Postal code must be 5 or 10. Okay. Oh, I enter 6. Okay. So we enter second address. So this is one address. And now enter second address. If I select this address, and I go to sequence, hit enter. So that basically means this address is for the purpose of receiving the good. So I can have this. So I have two addresses now. You can't do that in SD. So here we have a first address, that is my standard address, and I have a second address, which is to receive the goods. I want to put my third address. The third address is is Hazelwood Avenue, house number 444, postal code 12366, city South Carolina, South Carolina is the state, country, region, and hit enter. So now I got another address, which is Hazelwood Avenue, and if I select that, and that is sendable. So that basically means when I'm sending the bill, I'm sending at Hazelwood Avenue in South Carolina. So I have three addresses. The first one is a standard address, maybe like an head office. Second one is address for good recipient. And then third address is to send material. So similarly, I can enter as many addresses as I want. So let's say I want to enter 678. Sorry. So I want to enter 678 Cummins Road, house number 987, postal code 98651. City, Oakland, country, US, California, I enter another address. So now I have a Cummins Road in Oakland. And I want to add now another address. And I can add that address to any function I wanted to do. So now I have four different addresses. I want to change it. I can change also. So now I have a standard address, I have a good recipient address, send goods, send bill, and you can create many other actually. This is just an example. Okay. That is how. We can do addresses. Now I want to go to now these functions, and if I want to save, I can save it. So you can save multiple addresses. Okay. You can't do that in SD. SD1 business partner, you can only have one address. Now I want to go to something called account classification. Account classification options and account hierarchy functionality I want to work on. Account classification options and account hierarchy, these are functions are very important, and lot of these functions again you cannot do it in SD. Now the first one which you see here is called marketing activity. Marketing activity is very, very easy and very useful functionality. You can't do that in SD if you want to, and we're going to do this exercise. So the what you see at the figure 17, we can do this exercise. And that makes business partner function a very dynamic facility. Very dynamic facility. Because here, you can just create any attribute to a business partner. If I want to create an attribute to a business partner, say in SD, you can't do that. No such similar and equivalent functionality is available. You cannot do that. Okay. So now here, these are the marketing attributes. So let's say this is the attribute group called PC user. It's just an example. We're going to do that exercise as well. So here we can have a marketing group called PC user. And in the PC user, you have a these 1, 2, 3, 4 characteristics. One characteristic is application area. One is the level of expertise. Another one is the preferred channel. Another is a newsletter. So these are some of the marketing attributes. Now in this marketing attribute, we have a characteristic. So application area, the characteristic is office, multimedia, internet. Level of expertise, we have a beginner, advanced, expert. Preferred channel, we have a telephone, email, fax, text message. Newsletter, yes or no. Now, you can classify your customer in different ways. So you can classify your customer in different ways based upon any of the attribute. You can create attribute. You can create any attribute under the earth. On a planet, any kind of attribute, any way you want to do, classify a customer, you can classify those customers, and that you can do in SAP. And it is absolutely possible. Now here, we have these are the attributes, you can choose value. We're gonna, this exercise, which you're looking at the figure 17, this we're going to do. We're going to do this exercise. Make a note of these 1.5 lines. Make these 1.5 lines. make a marketing, and we have here something called marketing set. Marketing set basically means set of marketing attributes. This is another way of defining the classification of the customer. You can define different attribute, role, rating. My role is customer, my role is prospect, my role is competitor. What kind of rating? Is it a gold customer, silver customer? So that is also possible, which we do in day-to-day life. You can assign those attributes and all that, which we talked in last class also. This is the menu part where you can define these. It's a simple configuration actually. And then there is also a concept called account lifecycle. Now customers go through a lifecycle. So there is a complete lifecycle for a customer. Now where is the customer lifecycle? So here, lifecycle basically means role. So 1, 2, 3. Make a note of these three line items, please, which I highlighted on this screen, which is lifecycle. Okay, account lifecycle. So account lifecycle describes the functions which is done by make a note of that. Account life cycle. So basically, because life cycle goes to the different stages, and you will see some assignment block that basically means at the different stages of your life, what a customer can do and what a customer cannot do. So customer goes through different life cycle. Here's my potential is a customer stage one, stage two, stage three. You can go to different stages, and then we're gonna take a little break now. I could take rest. So 10 minutes break, and we're gonna do some exercises after that. It's a 10 minute break now. Okay, let's begin. We took a break. So we're talking about, I want to do an exercise. I want to do marketing attribute exercise. You want to do marketing attribute exercise. Okay. Wonderful marketing attribute exercise. Now, in the marketing attribute exercise, I want to create attributes and then attribute set, then assign attribute set to to business partner. Now, in the attribute, I want to go back to that slide. So I want to create an attribute called application area. And then we want to create level of expertise. Level of expertise. Okay. Then we want to create a preferred channel. And then we want to create newsletter. So these are the attributes I want to create. So make a note of that. So make a note of these, and then I want to create attribute set, and that is called application area. So basically, this picture which you have in the PDF, that picture we are doing, that picture we're going to talk about. Okay, that is what we're going to do. So, make a note, please. Make a note of that. So now, we go to SAP, back, and this is where we maintain attributes. Make a note of this menu path, please, where this attributes can be defined. Okay. So maintain attribute. You go to attribute. Now here, I create attribute number one, I call application area. So G F area start 12, 8, 18. So we call it application area format corrected. Now here in the values we can define office multimedia address. So we're going to use it in office, we're going to use it in multimedia. You cannot do all these functionality in SD. That's not possible. Office, multimedia, internet. Hit enter. Number of character, 16. Multi-value allowed. Okay. So we created an attribute. So we create one attribute called application area. Now I want to create another attribute called level of expertise. So now attribute Z label expertise. 8, 18, 18. We call it level of expertise. Okay. Format in character, 15 character long. And we have a beginner, advanced, and expert. We can have, he is a beginner, he is advanced or expert. Okay, and we save it. Now I want to create preferred channel. I go back G preferred channel. We call it preferred channel So in the preferred channel, we have a telephone, email, so what? So we put a 15 character. So if you want me to contact you to telephone, you want to be connected through email. You wanted to be connected through SMS or he wanted to be contacted through fax machine. I don't know who is using fax anymore. And this helps. Okay, so we save it. Okay, so this is another preferred channel. Okay. Now I have a newsletter. So I have another attribute. So we create attribute. So we created three: application leader, level of expertise. Level of expertise that also I've created. I make a note of it also. So all of them, we make all these. See, you can create. That's the beauty. That's the powerful. That's the power of it. You can create any attribute as you want. You have a choice. You can't do that in SD. That's why it's very powerful. If I go to new. So here I say Z news letter we call it newsletter. And here, correct them. Yes or no. And we save it. So we have created all these different functions. Okay, and back. Now, here we create attribute set. So now I have created these attributes. Now I want to create an attribute set. Attribute set is set of attributes. We create attribute set. Now in the attribute set, we click on the attribute set. And then we create attribute set here. And in the attribute set, and we call it the name for that is the PC user. So we call it the PC user. We call it PC user. Start 18. Now I want to assign attributes here. So I have these attributes which I have created. So I assign these attributes here. There is one. This is second. This is third. And the newsletter. So I can select maybe from the drop down. So eight newsletter. Okay, so this is the one. Okay, and then we save it. So we have created an attribute set called GPC user sadh 818. And this is my attribute set. Now I want to assign this attribute set to the business partner. Okay. So now I want to go back. I want to go to attribute set. And which you have created. So now I want to assign attribute set to the business, to a business partner, or we can directly go to business partner also. So either way is fine. So we go to business partner. We go to business partner. Business partner. We can use a business partner which we created today. So this was a business partner which we have created today, that Costco. Now here, if you look at carefully, we have a marketing attribute. So this is the marketing attribute. In a marketing attribute, if you go into drop down, and here you have all these different marketing attributes, attribute sets. These are all different attribute sets. Let's select the one. Okay, this is the one we created today. 818. 18. Oh, why 888? No, my too tired now, I guess. And then you assign. Now see here. The attribute which you created appears here. Application area. We have a lock version. Okay. So now if you come back here, if I double click, you can choose the value. You're going to use this in these three areas. Level of expertise. He's advanced. Preferred channel. He prefer email and SMS. He don't want phone. Needs letter. Yes, you can send the needs letter to him. Okay. So this is how you can create different you can create different attributes in SAP system. Okay. And and then we can save it. So business partner has been. Okay, so this is what we can configure, a lot of functions and functionalities. And with that, thank you all. And see you tomorrow. Thank you, everyone. Thank you so much. See you tomorrow, guys.